Now we're recording. Well, hell. I may have waited too long to put the wood in. The kindling started nice, but that was just the kindling. Well, I got a little more if that wasn't enough. Yes. I'm about as wide an angle as I can get. I hope I can fit all of us in here. Today, the sun is not set yet, so it's still daytime, but I'm getting ready for night with my little fire pit. It looks like the main piece of wood is caught okay, so I think we'll be okay. This is the second fire I've had with my bonfire. I had one a few nights ago to try it out, see how it was going. I have some snacks here, a little cheese. I also have some salami. I'm having a little cactus juice, my tequila, some of my favorite. Wow. It's just barely fitting into the screen, you know. It's like fire's down here and I'm up here, and the camera's just within reach where I can move it. Hear the wood talking. Yeah. Oh my. I think we need another piece. So here we go. Yeah. Now this little thing, this little fire pit, it's about 2 feet across and about 2 feet high. And I also bought the stand so I can set it on a wood deck if I have to. Hey, look over there. You see the sunset? That's the last light of the sun. This time of year, the sun sets right down the canyon. But in the summer, it will move north and we'll be more in shadow than we are now. Look, it's trying to catch. You see that right there? It's trying to catch on top. You hear the road outside? That's the biggest noise around here, is the street that's out there. goes up and down the canyon, up the hill, up there, and then down and down the canyon over there. You can hear the cars go back and forth. Especially now, because it is 4:45, and it's getting to be rush hour out here in the suburbs of San Diego. And people are coming home. There, you hear the quiet for a moment. For a moment, there's a little bit of quiet. I think the wood's going to catch very well. Good. Comes another car coming from there, going up that way. Yeah. Well, I lived here from 1959. In January, we moved in 1959. My parents bought the house in 1958 for $35,000. Of course, at that time, gas was less than 30 cents a gallon. Now it's $4 a gallon. It's more than 10 times higher. A Coke was 10 cents, and now it's $1 or $2, depending on where you go. It's either 10 or 20 times greater. My first job, I worked at a fast food hamburger joint in my senior year in high school. I made $1.40 an hour. And the last job I had, when I was 45 years old, before I ran away to Tijuana, I was making, well, let's see, I got about $500 a week. So I was making about 10 times, over $10 an hour. But that was almost 30 years ago, because I lived in Tijuana for 10 years. Then I lived with my mom in San Diego for 10 years. And now it's about 5 years later. Look at that. This is really an exquisite work of art. This, it's hot too. This solo stove. I bought a little one, about this big around and about this high, when I was going to go camping. And I used it when I was camping before I got sunstroke and had to go to the hospital a year and a half ago. And so this winter I decided I want to have a fire pit outside the house where I can sit out here in the evening. And in spite of all the noisy cars going by on the highway, I could sit here and have a drink. And have a bit of a snack. See, this is what I've got. Cheese and salami. Getting nice and hot. Don't want to melt the candle. So we moved in here almost 65 years ago. January of 1959. That's 63 years ago this month. Here goes the airplane. Oh, look at that. There's the moon. Let me show you something else here. See if I can get it. See if I can get the moon. Come on, where are you? There you are. Where are you? I saw you up there. There you are. Come on now. I know you're, yeah, there you are. There you are. Sweet moon. Damn it. Yeah. There's the crescent moon up there. The new moon was on Sunday. And today, therefore, is the fifth day of the moon, the sixth day of January, and the 17th day of winter. How many ages now have men and women built our bonfires and looked at the moon? How many ages have we gazed at the moon and decided who to sacrifice? There's the calendar. There's the candle. And there's my bonfire. Yes. It's pretty hot. Nice. I brought out my extra warmth with me. I'm just wearing a sweatshirt, which is what I wear during the daytime when the temperature's only 60-something. But now it's falling. The temperature's falling. It'll be in the 40s tonight, which for California is freezing. Now some of you folks, like Suja, you know what freezing really is. Course. Oh, there goes another airplane. As I was saying, we lived here beginning on January 31st, 1959. I have some memory of coming to the house before we moved in and talking with my parents, and they decided after 2 or 3 years of looking for a new house, because we lived in a two-bedroom house a few miles away from here in the hills of the suburbs of San Diego. In the same watershed, actually, because out there, down below this house, there's a ditch with a creek in it that runs down the hill and around the hills and turns and goes down. And it went down past a park where I used to go when I was a child. The same watershed as this is. It's a creek that drains into the Sweetwater River. Here in the suburbs of San Diego. So, when we moved, I really didn't want to leave the old house. I was very happy there. I had a big sandbox my daddy had built for me. I had been at that house from 3 years old to 8 years old, which are very formative years for a child. Those are the years when we learn how to read and write and do our arithmetic and reading, writing, and arithmetic. The three R's, as they're called. You hear that plane go by up above, overhead. Those are the two sources of the two main sources of noise here on this hillside. The highway. It's not a highway, it's just a road. But it sounds like a highway. There, you hear that car. And then the airplanes going by overhead, because we're right on the flight path for San Diego. They like to come here and bend around the hills and then go down into the city of San Diego. I think I'll have a piece of cheese. Yes. Anyway, I haven't made many video logs during the holiday season. So I decided that tonight, as Epiphany, as the sun sets, oh look. I believe the sun has set. You see, there's no more sunlight on the fence. Yep. So I decided that I would make a video log. My only holiday video vlog I think I've made this year. But I would do it tonight as Epiphany has ended. And this is either 12th night or last night was the 12th night. I'm not sure which. Or maybe last night was 12th night. Yeah, because yesterday was the 12th day of Christmas. That's right. This is Epiphany. The 12th day of Christmas was yesterday. So the holiday is now officially ending. Most people think Christmas begins either in September or after Halloween or after Thanksgiving. But the fact is, Christmas does not really begin until the 24th of December. Before that is Advent, which is waiting for the coming of the little baby who was born in a cave Virgin Mother of God, etc., etc., etc. In any case, yesterday was the 12th day of Christmas, and I resisted the temptation to make vlogs about all the days of Christmas, and just focus on writing. So I'm preparing a manuscript for a poetry competition that starts, excuse me, the deadline is January 14th. So I only have 8 or 9 days left before I have to mail it away or email it away, as it is now, submittable. Electronic submissions. My goodness, how things have changed since I was a young boy, since I was a young man. You used to have to mail everything with post office, postmark would prove the date that you sent it on. But now they all want you to email things. Except this contest, you're allowed to mail it with the post office. But they made it clear that that's an exception. That's a special treatment. They're still doing the old school. But the primary submissions are through electronic email submissions. And I've been working on that. Actually, I've been working on it for several months, because I knew about this contest several months ago, and I started to prepare the manuscript, collecting poems that I wrote in Tijuana, poems that I wrote before I moved to Tijuana, building almost a manuscript that's almost like my whole curriculum vitae poetis. Curriculum vitae poetis, my life and poetic curriculum. And so I haven't been thinking much about vlogging, although I've been watching the videos that appear on sites that I am fond of. Vloasis with Frank and the others, and of course good old Vloggerheads, which is still alive and kicking. And I've been thinking about, when would I make my next video log? And I decided this week, I decided that I would make my video log when the holidays are over, pretty much as the sun is setting and Epiphany is ending. The 12 days of Christmas were over yesterday, and today was the day when, according to the Christian mythology, the kings brought their 3 presents of gold and frankincense and myrrh. The 3 presents that these kings brought to the baby born in the cave, to the maiden mother. It's a very ancient mythology, but that's another subject. My subject tonight really is my house and my home. as I was saying, my parents bought this house in 1958. And we moved in January of 1959. And my mom lived here until 1978. Her first husband, my daddy, died in 1977. I was only 26. But I'd already moved out. That's another long story. But then when my mom remarried, an old friend of hers from San Diego, in 1978, and he asked her to come live with him in a nice house he had down in the city of San Diego. You've seen it if you've watched any of my vlogs. It's the house on the edge of the canyon. On the edge of Freeway Valley. And my stepfather died in 2007. And my mom asked me to leave Tijuana and come live with her and help take care of her in the house so that she wouldn't have to move out. And I lived with her from 2007 until 2018, when she also died. And then my stepbrothers and my stepsister, the three of them, were kind enough to let me live on there. And it wasn't until 2 years later that we finally started getting everything sorted out and put away, and I left that house in August of 2020. Now, when my mom left here in 1978, she began to rent this house. And from 1970, she didn't have the house straightened out until almost 1979, I think it was. But from 1979 until she died, 89, 99, 09, 40 years later, she rented this house. And my brother and I kept on renting the house to the people who were living here for another 2 years. And then we agreed we'd try to sell it. But my brother didn't like the price he was offered. So we'd sort of had an agreement that if we didn't sell it, I would move in. And then in a couple of years, he would join me here. So that's why I'm here, and that's why I've been living here since last July. 6 months, July to August, to September, October, November, December, and January. Almost 6 months now I've been living here. We have been keeping this house through the years. My brother, 8 years younger than I am, he's not retired yet. I am retired. I retired early, hell. But now I'm officially retired. My brother always wanted to retire here. And I suppose I could have argued with him and said we should sell the place and each take our half of the house and go our own ways. But I'd always had it in the back of my mind, back here somewhere, where my ponytail comes out. I'd always had it in the back of my mind that this might be a nice place to live, that I might actually be able to let my hair down and just have a really artistic life here, being alone on the hillside, writing, making video logs. And here I am, living alone on the hillside, making a video log. I've been at 32 minutes now, and you can see it's getting dark outside. Before I turned on the camera and lit the fire, I also turned on the light in the pool, and I turned on the light inside the house, so that I'd have a little bit of light when the time comes. Yes. So I'd have a little bit of light. Not just the beauty of the firelight, but the pool. And you can see over there the candle is now showing itself a little brighter. The sun has set, the moon up there is getting brighter, and I am not sure what to say. This is a very long vlog. It's probably going to be like one of my longest vlogs ever. I plugged the camera into the wall socket, so it's not going to run out of battery power. There's enough memory to go on for. This camera has a hard drive buried inside. And it has. It still has about an hour of space and memory. I don't think I'll go on that long, though. My idea was just to come out, light the fire, watch the sunset, have some hors d'oeuvres and something to drink, and pretty much get ready for the new year. I mean, it was new year 6 days ago, but That only means that the new year is only 6 days old. Yeah. That's beautiful warmth. Just magnificent. Heat from the fire. It's really nice. Yeah. I could have written a script, but I decided no. I'm just gonna take it from the top. Venus is gone for months. Venus was there in the west, hanging there. But now she's falling into the sun. In a few weeks, she will reemerge in the morning sky. But for now, her presence in the evening is gone. Soon Saturn will be gone, and Jupiter, if I can see right up there, not too far from the moon, and Jupiter will also be overtaken by the sun. The thing about these fire pits is they're completely self-contained. A beautiful piece of stainless steel work, and they hold the fire inside them, and yet they are incredibly warm. Incredibly hot. Right now, my leg here is about a foot and a half from the fire pit, and it's getting pretty hot. I'll tell you, it's getting pretty hot. I really like this thing. There goes the car. Let's see what time it is. The height of rush hour. The height of rush hour. Oh, look at that. The candle has burnt over its thing. The candle has spilled wax right over its candle holder, down onto my little camping table. Well, well. I think I'll just turn it around and see. The wind will make it burn the other way. Yes. Oh my goodness. It's getting dark. It's getting dark. A few minutes ago you could see this plate by the twilight, but not anymore. Whoop. Oh well. It's still delicious. Salami and cheese. Ah, there we go. We're getting part of what these fire pits are so famous for. You see, when they really get burning, they have a secondary burn. It comes out from those little holes around the edge of the... There's little holes all around the edge of the... All around the edge of the... of the pit. The air circulates up through the walls of the fire pit and it comes out towards the top and has a secondary burn around the ring of the fire pit that helps reduce the smoke. That's one thing that's really beautiful about these fire pits is the way they burn with much less smoke. There, you see the holes? See that row of little holes? Now, over here, ow, that's hot. It's getting so hot it's burning me. But over here, ow! Over here on this side, yow! The fire's coming out of the little holes. I believe it's on the left if you're looking at it. And it produces more flame and less smoke. Yeah. Man. That's hot. That is so hot now. And I sit here looking at it, and my face is heating up, and I just don't have to put on my coat. I brought a heavy coat out with me, because it gets cold at night here. Temperature drops, the other night it dropped below 40 outside. Oh, I do want to show you the swimming pool over there. See how it's all lit up? I turned on the light. And it's getting darker now. Yeah, it's getting a lot darker. Still twilight, there's still a glow in the sky in the west. And there will be all night long, because that's where the city is. The city of San Diego is over there, to the west. Way over there, over there. Over there. Over there. Over there. Send the word over there to beware. Because the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming. The drums rum-tum-tumming everywhere. Was a long time ago. That was a long time ago. The Great World War, 1914 to 1918, is more than 100 years ago now. Yes, it was. Many evenings I've come out here and just sat and watched the sunset turn into night as the twilight goes by. But this is only the second time I've had a fire in my fire pit. I've been thinking about buying this fire pit from Solo Stove, particularly the Bonfire model. This is the middle-sized fire pit. I've thought about it for months, maybe even longer. I do believe I was thinking about it even before I went camping and had heat stroke. But it wasn't until a couple weeks ago I decided I'm doing it. I'm going to spend a little bit of money, as it turned out it was almost $300 counting everything. But I bought it, and it was actually delivered on the 24th of December. And I went down the driveway of the house here. We live on the hillside, and there's a very steep driveway. And the delivery people, Federal Express, had decided they couldn't drive up the driveway. Well, they left it at the bottom, in a paved spot that turns off of the driveway. Now, I knew it was coming that day because I'd been following the tracking, as they call it. So when I went out a little before sunset on Christmas Eve, I drove down the driveway, and there it was on the side at the bottom. So I picked it up and I put it in the back of my wagon. And I drove off to spend Christmas Eve with my ex-wife and her husband-in-law. My husband-in-law, her husband. Nice guy. Really fine man. I'm glad she decided to go back with him. And I spent Christmas Eve with them, and we had lasagna and salad and played Scrabble. And I told her that I had bought a solo stove bonfire. And would you believe it? She's been daydreaming of buying the same thing. So one of these days, pretty soon, one of these nights, we're going to have a small gathering here with two of my dear old friends whom I've known since the 70s and the 80s here in San Diego, and my ex-wife and her husband. And the five of us will sit out here and have a little bonfire and roast weenies, although we may have to have fake hot dogs, because my ex-wife and her husband are mostly vegetarian. We may have to have faux weenies. But we'll sit out here and have a little bonfire and talk about times gone by. Now, I'm move the camera now, and I'm just about to say goodnight to you, my friends. But I do want to thank you. If you sat through this whole long video log, it's now almost 54 minutes. I want you to know, and I've been thinking of you. Some of you have been sharing videos with me since 2008. That's almost 15 years now. So, this is for you, my friends. My last holiday greetings. Salami and cheese. In the firelight. The last sip of tequila. I I wish you all a best new year. Baruch atah Adonai, Melech Ha'olam. Praise God, the Lord, King of the universe. Blessings be on you and on everyone. Peace, love, and understanding. Goodbye.